We do not want him to end up like cousin Tito.
Mommy, not again.
All right, Tito was a star student, a star athlete. He was gonna run track for Florida State. He thought he was golden, so he stops trying. He gets his first D. Next thing you know, jail. 25 to life.
I just don't understand what happened between the D and jail.
Welcome back to DBL. That was a scene from the new Disney Plus show, Diary of a Future President. It follows a Cuban American family, which is a big deal because Latinos make up only 3% of Hollywood characters and the U.S. is 18% Latino. Our Tori Shulman talked to two of the show's stars and they say this representation is long overdue. Check it out. Welcome to DBL. Already, Diary of a Future President is getting a ton of buzz for empowering young girls. Woo-hoo.
Please put your shoes on. You know, when my family came here from La Habana, we had to pack very light.
So shoes are a luxury, and I better appreciate mine. You said all this like a billion times.
But I want to know what else makes this show a must-watch from your point of view.
Aside from it being awesome and on Disney Plus, I would say that it's a wonderful like family show. Yeah. It's a celebration of this unique family, single mother, Cuban American household, and they're having a good time as they're navigating life. Mm. And you know, Elena is navigating middle school, and Gabby is navigating single motherhood and a lover.
Oh.
A love interest, I should say. A love interest.
Caliente. I love like that. That's amazing. Now, Selenis, you're no stranger to starring in shows that showcase women, which I love, from Orange is the New Black and now to this. But I want to ask you something. You're on a show where it's Latina women creating Latina characters with Latina people in the back of the camera. How important is representation on set for you?
Representation is key. You know, we talk about how there's a lack of Latinx representation in Hollywood,
yes.
But until we are in the writer's room, until we are producing and behind the camera, that will continue to happen. And this particular project is, what's wonderful about it is that it really is giving us an opportunity to tell our stories told by our people, written by our people, our voices, and that really does make a difference.
The more people at the table, the better the table is. I always agree. That's so wonderful. I want to know,
that's
Tess,
right.
If you were to become president, what would you do on day one?
I think I like your answer, which was really real. It's about snacks.
It's about snacks, and I'm trying to hide it. I'm trying to cover it. I can't keep running, okay?
She can't keep
it's
running
the
from
truth.
It. It's about it's, the snacks.
I what kind of, what yeah. is your favorite snack? What would you like, what's your go-to?
I love salt and vinegar Lays,
yes.
Also Doritos.
And how do you eat them?
I eat them with two little drink stirrers, like chopsticks.
That's the coolest thing I've ever seen.
It's pretty awesome.
You don't get any, we're just learning that Cheetos, it's called Cheetle, the dust, so you're not getting any Dorito dust on your hands. It's brilliant. It's brilliant. Very, very smart.
She's brilliant, I'm telling you. I have pictures to prove how brilliant she is.
There is evidence.
There is evidence. Now, a lot of our DBL Nation will be tuning in. I just want to say thanks for showing up and being at the table because it means a lot to the future generation. I'm really proud of both of you because more marginalized people means finally we get to see ourselves on TV. So thanks so much for being with us. I really,
right.
really appreciate that.
Bye.
Bye.